Are you still recording your calibration information on pen and paper? It's time to go digital with bMobile's bMobile calibration application. Hello, my name is Roy, and I'm with bMobile. At bMobile, our focus is making your lives easier. With the bMobile bMobile calibration application, you can get rid of your pen and paper. Leave it back at the office or in the truck. This is a calibration application that you can run on Android. You can run it on iOS. You can use a tablet or a phone or a Windows device. Huge number of options. You take this out into the field, record your calibrations. It also walks you through it so that everybody follows the same exact procedure. Uses the ability to link in the proper references that were used so that at the end, you can plug it into one of our calibration management systems and it gives you all of your information from the calibration, including traceability, the standards you used all the way back up to the national laboratory. The bMobile application can do a number of things like checklists for maintenance inspections. You can do weigh scales. You can do traditional transmitters or switches or displays. We'll give you a couple examples here coming up. So on my Android tablet, I first need to log in. I'll pick the user. It is possible to have data integrity here where you actually need a password to log in, so it is a secure system. I have two devices that I need to test. One is an oxygen analyzer, then I have a pressure transmitter. Let's start with pressure. Input 0 to 15 PSI, the output is 4 to 20 milliamps. We have three calibration points. More details. The first is a position. You might call this the tag or the tag name, tag ID. There's a device information. Then there's function. This describes what it is that you're testing. If it were a switch, it would have different parameters. And finally, the procedure itself. So let's get to it. Let's hit start. We have the graph. The blue lines represent our tolerance above and below. Remember, we're doing a 3-up test. I'll start by picking my references. All points. We use this standard for my input and this same standard for my output as well. And I can pick multiple references if necessary and hit OK. Nominal value. We're starting off at zero and say that my calibrator here, my reference is showing 0.0. 4 milliamps is my expected output and 399 is literally what I'm measuring here. So let me hit OK on that. Next, this is my 50% point. Nominal is 7.5, and that's ideal. With pressure, it's difficult to get it exact unless you're using a smart positioner or a smart pressure regulator. Let me go 7.49. We say that's the actual pressure going in. We're expecting 12 milliamps out, and 12.01 is what I am reading on this one. And next point, this will be our high point or 100%. 15.02 or 15.02. Hit OK. Output, we're expecting 20 milliamps. And we get a trend on the graph. So it did pass. We have maximum error, most significant. And on the very bottom here, free fields, you can put in custom fields that will help you document your processes. Environmental conditions. If you need to record your environmental temperature, your barometric pressure maybe, you document that here. So this is my favorite part. These are all the points, all the numbers that, number one, I didn't have to calculate, but I don't have to type them in anywhere because they're already in here. And they're going to go electronically back to my calibration management system. And the graph. I think they put the images in for me, so I appreciate that. Save it. I can save it as found, or I can save it as both, if that fits your SOP better. I'm gonna save it as found, hit OK, and now I'm done. If for any reason I needed to, I could do another repeat. You may have an instance where you take a number of as founds, and then you average those results. You can do that. Let me go back here, I'm done. We've completed our pressure transmitter. Now it's time for the oxygen analyzer. And this can be a pH analyzer, it can be anything. And oftentimes you're not going to have a documenting calibrator to be able to grab all this information. So it's easier to type it into this bMobile application. All right, here's my gas analyzer. In this example, the technician has a formula that they use for relative accuracy, and they actually perform three calibrations, three sets of data, and then it will get an average after the fact. I'll be doing one. 0 to 100% on the input and the output. Let's hit start. So this is a two-point test. We have a gas that's calibrated to 5.05%, and then we'll measure what that indication is on the output. Oh, you know what? I need my reference. So reference on the first point, not all points. I want a reference for this point specifically. And it's in my sample gases, and it's literally this guy, the 5.05% standard. Hit OK. And once I have that, now I can put in my data. So my gas is 5.05. I already know that. So let me put that in here. And we'll see that the display itself is showing 5.02. So there's a little bit of a deviation. We'll go to our next test point. That's 8.03%. Go to my references. I'll select my reference for this one specifically. So that's my sample gas here. And here's my 8%. There we go. Reference done, check. Now let's enter our next value. So our nominal here, we're expecting 8.03. That's what our gas is, 8.03. Our display, we're going to say is 8.01. Okay, this did pass as well, so same thing. We get a maximum error displayed. And let me just start on the bottom here. We have the same free fields that were predefined to start with. And you don't need to use those. Environmental conditions, what's the ambient temperature? Well, you can put that in. Here's our point numbers. And then we get the graph again. Now save it. I'll save this as found, and I'm done. Now, I mentioned before doing three repeats and then getting average information. I could hit next repeat and accomplish that right here, but I'm done right here. Our calibrations are complete. We've got both of them. The last step is to upload it into our bMobile calibration software. Then you're finished. Now, if you'd like more information on this device, you can actually download our bMobile app for free. Go to the Play Store, go to the App Store, type in bMobile. Once you install that, you can enter demo mode. Just hit these three lines on the top, go into demo mode, and we'll show you a nice selection of different types of devices that are commonly calibrated, and you can take a look at those. Checklists, transmitters, switches, etc. For more information, check out our website. Thanks for watching.